Welcome friends. So let's start with the reactive intermediate part 5. So we have a benzaldehyde and we have given TMSCN, which is a source of cyanide, right? So what will happen? PaHCHO in presence of TMSCN, it will form OTMS. Right. Okay. Now you have given LDA. So what LDA does? It's a base, right? So it will abstract this proton. This is acidic proton. Okay. OTMS. Okay. And this carbanion is stabilized by the phenyl group as well as the cyanide group, right? Now you have given isopropyl iodide. So you have given a isopropyl iodide. So basically this will attack here, which leaves the iodine. So it will be like OTMS, and here we have isopropyl. And the next step we have given H plus in water. So just hydrolysis. So if you do a hydrolysis reaction, so this OTMS group will become a OH group, right? Okay, now again we have given a base, so there is a proton abstraction, right? So the proton will be abstracted from here, so there is a proton abstraction. And then what happens, since cyanide is a good leaving group, this electron cloud pushes and cyanide leaves. So it's a kind of, means it's not benzene condensation, but it's type of benzene condensation, like, right? So this is our product. So let's move to the second one. So the second one is, we have a silicon group, we have a double bond, right? So we have an electrophile like CH3COCl, okay? So this pi bond will attack this carbonyl carbon, and which, and it will leave this Cl because it's an electrophile. It's like a feral carb acylation type, okay? So if it attacks, if there are two possibilities, either COCH3 will be here and positive charge here, or COCM3 here, positive charge here. Okay, so which one will go? So if I tell that this one will go, right? So what's the reason behind that? You know, beta silicon effect. Okay, so if there is a beta carbocation, okay, adjacent to silicon, so if this is a silicon, this is alpha position, this is a beta position, okay, and here it is a alpha, this is a beta, this is gamma position, but this is beta silicon effect. So if there is a positive charge in the beta position of a silicon group, so that is stabilized, right? And if there is now what happens, so this will not form, this will not form, okay, this will not form. So now we have Cl minus in the reaction medium, so the Cl minus will attack the silicon, okay, and this will form a double bond. So like we are getting, this is our product, right? So just predict where the carbocation is forming. If the carbocation is forming at the beta position with respect to silicon, then that will be the stable intermediate. Then just the Cl minus will attack and it will form a double bond. So this is called beta silicon effect, Right. Now, the next one is based on again a scene elimination, pyrolytic scene elimination. Sorry, it's a scene elimination, and this reaction is it's a Chugev reaction. It's a Chugev reaction, right? So we have OH, right? So you have given a sodium hydride, so it will abstract this proton, and you have carbon disulfide. Okay, so it will attack here, right? Fine. So we are getting C S- double bond S, and we have a methyl iodide in the medium. It will attack the methyl, it will go away, right? So we are getting a O C double bond S SME. Now we have given heat, that means elimination. So elimination, so there are two possibility. Either here one hydrogen is here the hydrogen is above, and here both hydrogens are present, one above, one below. So this reaction, this will undergo scene elimination, means same phase elimination. So it will not take up this hydrogen because this group is below the plane and this hydrogen is above the plane. So it will take up this hydrogen, right? So this pi bond will take up this hydrogen. Here are double bond and Cl. So this, so we are getting this as the major product, right? Also, we are getting back CO, SH, and SN. Right, so this is the major product. So this is the main product. So in the option, they will give here a double bond, here a double bond, like this they will give. So just identify the syn hydrogen. Okay, so that's all for the video, and hope you like this video, and I will upload more videos on reactive intermediates. Thanks for watching.